So let's look at what are the different types of business organizations. Essentially, three types that we deal with, or largely today the business world has, are so-called sole traders or sole proprietors, partnerships, and limited companies. Now, what are sole traders? These are owner working for themselves. These are people who run their own businesses, single persons running their own business, like shopkeepers or hairdressers or carpenters or plumbers, electricians, and so on and so forth. Remember, they are responsible not only for themselves as person, but also for the business. So if they borrow money, it means that they have a personal responsibility to pay that money back. It is not necessary. That is, the business is not differentiated from the individual. In the eyes of the law, the business and the individual are same. So if they owe money, the individual has to pay out of his assets. This doesn't mean that the sole proprietor cannot employ people. It doesn't mean that he only runs the business, but he can always employ people to run the business, but the responsibility lies with him. Partnership is nothing but more than one sole proprietor coming together and sharing the benefits and the risks of the business. So here also, like the sole proprietor or sole trader, the partners are personally responsible for any amount that would be owed by the business. So in case I want a structure or an organization structure which wants to avoid this responsibility for paying the amounts owed by the business, then people move on to formulating what are known as limited companies. The word limited basically means that the owners have limited liability. Let me give you an example. Suppose we want to start a business and 10 of us get together and say we have a capital of 10 lakhs each to put. Then we decide that each will have a 10% share in that organization or that business, and each of us will put 10 lakhs. Then incorporate. Basically, as I said, a company is incorporated under law. In India, for example, there is a body of the government of India called Registrar of Companies, where I need to go and register. Once it is registered, those kind of formalities may not be required for partnerships and sole proprietors or traders. So when I register, after that registration, in law, I am considered, the business is considered as a separate person compared to or in respect to the owners. The owner's ownership and the business is not mixed up. The business is a separate person, the owners are separate persons. So the 10 of us who have put 10 lakhs or committed to put 10 lakhs each can now pay in that 10 lakhs. That is the maximum liability that I have incurred towards that business. I need to put in 10 lakhs. So those who have put in 10 lakhs already into the business to create the share capital of 1 lakh, 1 crore, then there is no further requirement, no further liability at their end to put the money. That is why it is called as limited liability. So the owner's responsibility is only for the amount to be paid to the company for their shares or for the part of the company that they will own. So that is the major advantage of a limited company. So from a legal perspective, as I said, sole traders and partnerships are not considered separate from their owners. They have to own up all the liabilities that their business has and pay out of their personal assets if required. A limited company, however, is a separate entity. As I said, it is considered as a separate entity in the eyes of the law. It is a separate person in the eyes of the law, and it therefore can enter into contract in its own name. And the owners of that company or limited company are only responsible for what they have committed to pay as their part of the share of the capital into that particular company. So if vis-a-vis sole traders and partnerships, what are the advantages and disadvantages of limited companies? Let's take a quick look at that. The advantages is, as I said before, limited company makes the investment less risky because you know upfront what you're committed, and that is the only amount that you need to put in. It is easier to raise finance. Generally, banks and other lenders find it easier to deal with a limited company for lending money. They find that to be a better organization structure to lend money than other proprietors and partnership kind of firms. The other also aspect is that number of shareholders can be many, and therefore you can bring in new owners as and when required, who just pay in the money and take a share of their profit as and when the profit is made. So it's easier to raise finance. Thirdly, since it is a separate person, the owners can keep changing, but this entity as a company will remain and can have a very long life. The company, the business can keep doing, can happen continuously. There is no need to stop any business just because owners are changing. The owners will change, new things, new procedures or new products and new markets may come in, but the entity in its name exists and can exist for infinite time, which is not the case with partnerships and sole proprietors, because if a partner or a sole proprietor dies, then you have to reorganize the whole situation again. That is not the situation with companies. Then in tax advantage is another thing where in sole proprietors and partnerships, you will find that both at the business level and at the individual level, taxes have to be paid. The business is taxed as well as the individual, the sole trader or the partners are also taxed. But here, the owners are separated from the business entity, because the business entity is a person by itself. It is taxed separately and then it is therefore separated from the owners. Then easy to transfer the ownership. Suppose the shares are there, as I said, 10 of us have got together. Tomorrow I want to leave with my 10% share. I can just go sell the shares. Somebody else can come in, and therefore the ownership change, part ownership change also becomes easy, which is not that simple in a partnership or a sole proprietorship. But all these advantages come with a lot of disadvantages. Because of these advantages, the regulation on these limited companies is very high. Since we are not going to be personally responsible, the law has a fairly good hold on how these companies are organized, performs, etc. For example, there are requirements on how many, the way you have to publish the financial status. Every year, it is compulsory for these companies to publish their financial status, and this financial status is available to the public. That means my competitor and other people can easily know what is my situation. Secondly, there are legal, and that this goes along with this, and accounting requirements. Now, for example, the Companies Act in India makes it compulsory and tells you what all are the various financial details that need to be disclosed in the financial statements. And as far as accounting is concerned, in India, for example, we have what is called as the Institute of Chartered Accountants, which has a body of eminent accounting experts who lay down as to how, what are the various accounting standards. That is how you have to deal with every transaction that takes place in the business, how that accounting should be done. And that is something that limited companies have to follow, which may not be that crucial for the partnerships and So all the advantages also come with caveats of a lot of legal regulations going into limited companies. Also, certain limited companies over a certain level are required to do audit. Now, what do you mean by audit? Audit means review by an independent body. An independent body or an independent organization should come and check your books and say that whatever you are publishing is indeed a true and fair view of the business in terms of its financial status. Now, this can be time consuming as well as expensive. Again, when we need to bring in more owners, and especially if you want to go and list yourself in the stock exchange to bring in the public as also part owners in companies, then the procedures, the legal procedures that are required can be pretty lengthy and also expensive. So also, if you want to reduce the ownership, there also the legal requirements can be fairly onerous, and the process also can be expensive and time consuming. So vis-a-vis partnerships, while there are major advantages, there are some disadvantages. So unless the scope of the business is reasonably big, where the cost of complying with all the legal requirements overweighs the benefits, then there is no point. But if it is It makes sense only when the benefits outweigh the costs of, otherwise it's better to have a partnership or a proprietorship type of organization.